welcome to Christian Senior Recital. I am glad all of you are here today. Just want you to know that Christian will of course play a number of pieces. There will be a period right in the middle-ish where Rebecca and Jack will play a few pieces in order to give Christian's fingers a little bit of a rest. And so I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Of the Romantic era, who wrote in a wide range of musical genres, including symphonies, concerti, film music, operas, and ballets. The Harp Prelude is the seventh of the 10 pieces that Sergei Prokofiev composed between 1906 and 1913 while a student at the St. Petersburg Conservatory. He premiered it on the piano in 1914, and the piece has since become famous for both pianists and harpists.
Thank you.
13 in B major by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart was one of the most influential, popular, and prolific German or Salzburgian composers during the classical era. Mozart was considered to be a rare musical genius, though he was diligent in studying other great composers such as Haydn and Bach. Mozart's music is characterized by its elegance, clarity, and emotional depth. Nearly all his music was composed in the classical style, which emphasized structure and balance.
Thank you.
Russians Back to play Etude No. 31 by Karl Czerny. Karl Czerny was an Austrian composer, teacher, and pianist of Czech origin whose music spanned the late classical and early romantic eras. Czerny studied under Beethoven at a very young age and was so successful that Beethoven chose to have him perform the premiere of his first and fifth piano concertos. Eventually, Czerny began a very successful teaching career. His most famous student, Franz Liszt, required advanced practice material, so Czerny composed this Etude No. 31, The Art of Finger Dexterity.
Thank you.
Barber of Seville by Giacchino Rossini. He was an Italian composer during the late classical and early romantic era, known for his operas, Wilhelm Tell, The Barber of Seville, The Thieving Magpie. Rossini's music has always been greatly enjoyed by everyone. Wagner said his music was a melodic invention. This piece is a reduction of The Barber of Seville for piano duet. Sorry.
few words. I'll talk about Christian a little bit, about all of you. Christian. Speak loudly. Christian, as you close out your high school career and now look forward to your college career and your life, you might ask, what is required of you now? Let me suggest to you that that you consider this well-known but rarely applied verse, this passage from Scripture from Micah. Micah 6:8 is written in the form of a question and answer. The question posed is, what does the Lord require of you? The answer is provided: to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. To walk humbly with your God, Christian, as you consider answering that question, what does the Lord require of me? Consider the idea of humbleness. As you look back on your high school career and then look forward to your college career and your life, I want you to see that having a humble spirit is key to being a good learner. And being a good learner is key to being a good student. That is teachable. And a good student is a joy to his parents and to his teachers. In this sanctuary, Christian, there are 70 plus people who, by being here, are expressing their joy in you. They have poured their lives and experiences into you. They have taught you, and you have learned from them. It should also be humbling to you to think that these 70 people here are about, supposing the average age is around 30, that's conservatively 30. Thank you, Mother, for bringing the average up for us, represents 70 people, and 30 represents, you do the math here, more than 2,000 years of experience from which you have learned. Today's recital is an expression of your joy of learning, and indeed in excelling, and it is also a gift to all of us who have taught you. Musically, Christian has achieved a high level of proficiency, played very difficult pieces to which his teachers can attest, and he has performed and competed in many competitions and recitals through his career. As a homeschool student, you've had the privilege of teachers from so many walks of life and from all over the world, from South Africa to South Stafford. You're privileged. But it would be reasonable and safest for me to acknowledge your mother, who's been your primary teacher, and who can still understand your math better than you, and who can still beat you in ping pong. Christian, your grandparents are here, who gave us a heritage of Christian faith. Grandparents here, and your grandmother here. That's valuable. Don't forget it. Your uncles and aunts and cousins are here too, who've taught you so much. Your brother and sisters, who you've at least learned to tolerate. That's learning. You've learned much from all of them. As you are more STEM science-oriented, Christian, and I simply more humanities-oriented, I've had less of an academic engagement with you on a day-to-day basis. But as many of you know, Christian is a bit of a mad scientist, having turned much of our basement into various laboratories. And to this end, I was less a teacher and more of the albino and hunchbacked assistant to his Dr. Frankenstein. In one experiment gone wrong, I can recall a car battery attached to a canister that contained various chemicals designed to produce some sort of propellant ignited, and he was safely afar away, but I was not. It exploded in my face and into my ear. Yes, it was rough. I frequently also feared a visit from the FBI or the ATF, given my Amazon orders of so many curious components and chemicals from which Christian built stun guns, rail guns, coil guns, and his own arc welder, which he recently used. Now, Christian is interested in medicine, and in preparation for that, many things were dissected in our basement. My mother and his grandfather and grandmother helped him dissect his first squirrel when he was very young. We hope Christian's patients fare better than that as he pursues maybe medicine in his later career. Christian, you're a good student. You were a good student. Academically, Christian has achieved a 4.0 GPA while taking challenging classes at home via co-ops, online dual enrollment courses, and at Germana. Angie is not an easy grader. I should know. Some of our neighbors are here, the Joneses and the Stralings, both regularly gave Christian side jobs. Mr. Mike, as we call him, encouraged Christian's entrepreneurial spirit, giving him his first time, his first job, a mowing job. And we appreciate that, Mike. The Joneses are here too. They finally moved into our neighborhood and brought Christian a friend, and for which we are very grateful, and Blake. Those two have spent time fishing, hiking, breaking into abandoned farmhouses. I'll just rephrase that. They explored farmhouses around the area. The Joneses welcomed Christian into their home so warmly and into their family. Musically, Christian is gifted, as you can see. He is also a very good piano student. And we thank Judy Hinson, Veronica Allison, and Larissa Felt here, who have just really nurtured Christian's giftedness in music. And we appreciate you. Thank you. Christian, as you can see, can play very softly. It wasn't always the case. Jonathan Allison, who's in our church, the music director at our church, can attest to this, that Christian used to be very heavy on the piano, like hammers on the piano. He banged hard, and I think Mr. Allison was always fearful that he would break our church piano. Christian's learned finesse, and we appreciate that. Mr. Allison gave Christian so many good opportunities to grow musically, too. And now bikes, Trek bikes specifically, naturally. At a very young age, as a young teen, Christian dreamed of working at a Trek store, which opened up to him, and it turned out that he got a job there. And it opened up a huge, dynamic, and diverse biking community to him. This gave Christian so many new friends, so many of whom are here, some dangerous friends, Jonathan, but all who encouraged his growth. His team, coaches, taught him to compete and enjoy biking. To his biking friends, co-workers, employers, teammates, and coaches, thank you so much for investing in Christian. Christian improved remarkably competing in bike racing, moving from 42nd place last year to an overall fourth place in his category this year. It's remarkable, Christian. It was fun to watch you improve. Christian also earned a third degree black belt in Taekwondo. Master Ha, Master Steve, and so many other Taekwondo friends taught Christian to be tough, to be manly, to be principled, and to be hardworking. Steve Conroy, who's here, can attest that Christian survived self-defense classes. Christian was usually the only kid in that class, usually being tossed around like a rag doll by a bunch of grizzled Marines. It was rough, and he survived it and kept on going. Steve, he learned from you. He learned to be tough. So Christian, be humble, be a learner, be teachable, and you will continue to be a joy to your teachers and to your friends, to your family, and to your colleagues. This fall, Christian will attend Liberty University, where he'll major in biomedical sciences with the goal of a medical school. He is looking forward to racing on Liberty's biking team and continuing to use his musical gifts. Now, Christian, since we homeschool, we use this as an opportunity to provide you a diploma, Andrew. And we would now like to present you. We would like you now to present you your diploma. Thank you. coming. Keith, we have you close us. Keith Duff, have you close us in prayer, after which please join us for a reception afterwards to congratulate Christian and just talk and enjoy our time together. Thanks.
Wow. Awesome. Really great. Let me pray for us. Lord, we just thank you for just the wonderful skills that you've given to Christian, Lord. If it's playing piano, if it's bike racing, Lord, if it's figuring out a math problem that most of us wouldn't even understand the concepts of, Lord, we thank you for the skills you've given him. Thank you for the teachers you've given him to develop those skills. Lord, I thank you for his diligence. Lord, as he invests his all in developing the skills you've given him. Lord, I thank you even more than that for the character that you've given him, the love for you that you've instilled in him. Lord, I thank you for his desire to use the skills, the character, the training, the mentoring, Lord, for you and for your kingdom, Lord. So we pray your blessing on him, Lord, as he moves from high school stage to college stage, and Lord, as he continues to develop and grow and mature, Lord, we just ask you to continue to be with him, continue to bless him, Lord, continue to grow him. Lord, we know you have great plans for him and for his life, and we just thank you for that. We thank you for the ways you use us, Lord, in our strengths and in our weaknesses, and Lord, certainly Christian has those as well, and you'll use those things for your good and for your glory. And so, Lord, I thank you for that. Lord, I thank you for the opportunity to be part of his life, and Lord, just ask that you do great things and use him in great ways. And Lord, that you'd continue to nurture his heart. Lord, that as he grows and matures, that the number one area that he focuses on is his relationship with you and serving you and bringing honor to you. So Lord, thanks for the ways you do that in our lives. And Lord, we just pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.